person is very straightforward. The first lesson taken from Exodus chapter 13. Yes, 2-3.
The Lord spake unto Moses saying,
yes.
Sanctify unto me
all the firstborn.
Whosoever opens
the womb
among the children of Israel.
Both of man and of beast. Yes.
It is mine.
It's mine.
And Moses said unto the people,
yes.
Remember this day
unto the Israelites he was talking. Yes.
In which he came out from Egypt.
Yes.
Out of the house of bondage.
Yes.
For by strength of hand.
By the outstretched mighty hand of God.
The Lord brought you out from this place.
Yes.
There shall no living bread be eaten.
There shall be no living bread. No yeast in your bread. It must be bread of sorrow. Yes.
This day came ye out in the month of Abib.
The month of Abib.
And it shall be when the Lord shall bring thee into the land of the Canaanites and the Hittites and the Amorites and the Hivites.
The month of Abib is the first month in the calendar year of the Israelites. The first month for the general world is January. The one for Israel is spiritual, is the month of their migration out of the land of bondage, which was in March, April. So they reckon their own month from March, April. It's not from January. And they call it Nisan, or Abib. Yes.
And the Jebusites.
Yes.
Which he swear unto thy fathers to give thee a land flowing.
Sanctify all the male that open the womb unto me, for there are my possessions. I'm not going to belabor you because I want you to get back home very early so that you can prepare for another this job tomorrow. It's very, very important. You've been here since yesterday, but we will not do it in vain by the grace of God.
Amen.
Jesus. We're going to cut everything short, short, short. The service is already long. The point is, the firstborn is so crucial to God. The Lord regards the first male that opens the womb as holy unto him. There's a big battle over the firstborn. Because the firstborn directs and dictates the tune of the family. The firstborn appears the heir apparel. Other children within the family tend to follow the firstborn. So the first male is so crucial to God, is so crucial to Satan. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In Exodus 12, the Lord decided to kill the entire firstborn of the Egyptians.
For I will pass through the land of Egypt this night.
I will pass through.
And will smite all the firstborn of the land of Egypt.
I will smite all the firstborn of Egypt.
Both man and beast.
From the child of the king to the last person. Yes.
And for both man and beast.
Yes.
And against all the gods of Egypt.
Yes.
I will execute judgment.
I will execute judgment. I will kill them because I don't want their attitude to permeate. So when you have a firstborn who is a male, you know you have a special prayer continuously, not continually, continuously over that individual. It's the holy of the Lord. It's of the Lord. It's not for the Lord. It's possession of the Lord. And Satan is saying, it's going to be for me. The Lord destroyed all the firstborn of the Egyptians. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because Christ is the firstborn of God. With his blood, the houses of the Israelites were marked. Get 1 year old lamb without any blemish, white, no infirmity. Make sure you pour the blood, slaughter that, pour the blood in a bowl, and use a bunch of hyssop, like a painter, to put a mark on top of the lintel on the right hand, on the left hand. When I see the blood of my son, that destructive angel will pass over. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Of course, when Christ was born physically, Satan also came into Herod, not only wanting to kill Jesus, because they told you somebody has just delivered. That child cannot be more than 8 days, 10 days, 1 month. Instead of asking them to kill a month old, you said, anybody from 2 years old, slaughter them. The first lesson and the second lesson are the same. Just read 21, 22.
And when 8 days were accomplished,
yes,
for the circumcising of the child,
yes,
his name was called Jesus.
Yes.
His name was called Jesus, which was so named of the angel before he was conceived in the womb.
Yes.
And when the days of her purification, according to the law of Moses, were accomplished, they brought him to Jerusalem,
yes,
to present him to the Lord.
Yes.
As it is written in the law.
It's written in the book of the law.
Every male that openeth
the every womb, male that opens the womb
shall be called holy.
Shall be called only for the Lord.
And to offer a sacrifice.
And to offer a sacrifice unto the Lord by that baby.
According to that which is said.
With a pair of dove.
A pair of turtle doves or 2 young pigeons.
Or two young pigeons. Pigeons as little baby doves. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
They are of the Lord. And that is why firstborns are always moving through the turbulence of life. They are battered from left, right, and center. They are battered spiritually. They are battered financially. They are battered physically. Because the firstborn is a soul that Satan and Christ are struggling to possess. God is saying, they are holy unto me. They are my possessions. And that is why, please let there be concentration, please. The firstborn will be tempted. There will be temptation, serious one. And there will be trials. Satan will shake them, will storm their lives, will oppress them. That is why when you have a male child as a father, you must be full and filled with prayer for that individual. Reuben was the firstborn of Jacob. Simon was the second born. They both fell. Genesis 48.
And it came to pass after these things.
Yes.
That one told Joseph, behold, thy father is sick.
They told Joseph, your father is sick.
And he took with him 2 sons, Manasseh and Ephraim.
Those are the 2 children, yes.
And one told Jacob and said,
yes,
behold, thy son Joseph cometh unto thee.
Yes.
And Israel
because Jacob could no longer see properly again. Yes.
And Israel strengthened himself and sat upon the bed.
Yes.
And Jacob said unto Joseph,
yes,
God Almighty appeared unto me at Luz in the land of Canaan.
Yes.
And blessed me.
Yes.
And said unto me,
yes,
behold, I will make thee fruitful and multiply thee.
I will multiply thee.
And I will make of thee a multitude of people.
Yes.
I will give this land to thy seed after thee for an everlasting possession.
Yes.
And now thy 2 sons, Ephraim and Manasseh.
Ephraim and Manasseh.
Which were born unto thee in the land of Egypt.
Which were born unto in the land of Egypt.
Before I came unto thee.
Before
in
I
Egypt,
came unto thee.
They are mine.
I will not, I'm taking them, they are no longer your own.
As Reuben and Simon,
I'm going to replace Reuben and Simon.
They shall be mine.
I'm going to replace Reuben and Simon with your own children, Ephraim and Manasseh. I'm dropping off Reuben, who is my firstborn. I'm dropping off Simon. I'm making Ephraim and Manasseh. Yes.
And thy issue which thou begettest after them,
yes,
shall be thine.
Yes.
And shall be called after the name of thy brethren in their inheritance.
Why will God do that? Why will God do that? See the blessing upon Reuben in 49 chapter, verse 1 to 3.
And Jacob called unto his sons.
And Jacob called upon his sons.
And said.
And said.
Gather yourselves together.
Gather yourselves together. I'm now old and preparing to go unto the track and the path of all the living. Yes.
Gather yourselves together and hear, ye sons of Jacob.
Yes.
And hearken unto Israel your father.
Yes.
Reuben.
Reuben.
Thou art my firstborn.
You are my firstborn.
My might.
My might.
And the beginning of my strength.
The beginning of my strength.
The excellency of
dignity. The excellency of, yes.
And the excellency of power.
Of power.
Unstable as water.
You are very unstable.
Thou shalt not excel.
You will never excel. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Is that blessing?
No.
Yes.
Because thou wentest up to thy father's bed.
You went on to your father's bed.
Then defiledst thou it.
And you defiled it.
He went up to my couch.
You went on to the wife of your father. 35:22. Genesis 35:22.
And it came to pass,
yes,
when Israel dwells in that land,
yes,
that Reuben went.
Reuben went
and lay with Bilha.
And lay with Bilha,
his father's concubine.
His father's wife. Jacob had four wives. Leah, who gave him six sons and one daughter, Dinah. And when Rachel could not bear, so now you have to go into bed with my maid, Bilha. And Jacob did. Now Reuben went to bed with the father's wife. The father did not say anything, but at the 0 hour, there was proclamation of woes. You will never excel. His temptation from Satan always trying to derail the first ones. He will come with temptation, he will come with trial, he will come with whatever strategy to make sure that first son is unprofitable. Because take care of the shepherd, the sheep will be scattered. The firstborn is the shepherd of the house. And that is why we must be full of prayer for our children. It is very, very important that the Lord uphold them, that the Lord sustain them,
amen,
that evil communication has destroyed all their ways,
amen,
because they are passing through tunnels of difficulties, trials, and temptation. Christ was the firstborn, and is the firstborn among the living. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
They are holy unto the Lord. They are of the Lord. They must therefore live their lives in holiness, in righteousness. Nobody can subdue them. Nobody can overcome them as long as they are in line with the Lord. The Lord now transfer. Can you go to the blessing on Joseph?
Joseph is a fruitful bow.
This was the greatest blessing. Even greater than that of Judah, which is the lineage of the Lord Jesus Christ. Yes.
Joseph is a fruitful bow.
Yes.
Even a fruitful bow by a well.
Yes.
Whose branches run over the wall.
Yes.
The archers have sorely grieved him.
Yes.
And shot at him.
Yes.
And hated him.
They hated him. His brethren, they shot at him. Yes.
But his bow abode in strength.
Yes.
On the arms of his hands were made strong by the hands of the mighty God of Jacob.
Yes.
From thence is the shepherd, the stone of Israel.
Yes.
Even by the God of thy father, we shall help thee.
Yes.
And by the Almighty, we shall bless thee with blessings of heaven above.
Yes.
Blessings of the deep that lies under.
Blessing from above. Blessing from deep under.
Blessings of the breast and blessings of the womb.
Blessing of the breast and of the womb.
The blessings of thy father.
The blessing of thy father, Jacob.
Have prevailed above the blessings of my progenitors.
Yes.
Unto the utmost bound of the everlasting hills.
Yes.
They shall be on the head of Joseph.
They will be on the head of Joseph.
And on the crown of the head of him that was separate from his brethren.
Yes. He will be the prince over all his brethren. Because he was tried. He was turned, he stood firm, and consequently, Jacob the father made Ephraim the child, the son of Joseph, his own first son by adoption. And also, Manasseh, his second son, to replace Simon. Simon was charged for anger. He was a man of anger. A patient of anger.
Cursed be the anger.
Yes.
For it was fierce.
Cursed be their anger, for it is fierce.
And their wrath, for it was cruel.
Their wrath is cruel. Yes.
I will divide them in Jacob and scatter them in Israel.
I will divide his portion. I will scatter him. That was his blessing for Simon. Is that blessing? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And the prayer of the aging parents are so crucial because it's more or less a prophecy that can never be reversed. The firstborn, Christ said, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, the time will come and is now in, when the Son of Man shall visit those who are dead, he will go into hell, and he make a separation of sins and the condemned, and make those who are righteous to become the first fruits. Verily, verily, I say unto you," that's in John 5, from 25 to 27, 28. And what happened in Matthew 27, 50, 51, 52, the veil of the temple was rent.
Jesus
worked. Yes.
When he had cried again with a loud voice.
Yes.
Yielded up the ghost.
Yes.
And behold, the veil of the temple was rent.
Yes.
In twain from the top to the bottom.
Yes.
And did earth did quake.
Yes.
And the rocks rent.
Yes.
And the graves were opened.
Yes.
And many bodies of the saints which...
The bodies of the saints were raised, but they were not allowed to come out of their grave. Yes.
And came out of the graves after his resurrection.
They came out of their grave after Christ had come out. The point I want you to understand is that in Revelation 14, verse 1, 2, 3, 4, the Lord is saying something.
And I looked, and lo, a lamb.
Yes.
Stood on the Mount Zion.
Yes.
And with him 140 and 4,000.
And with him 144,000.
Having his father's name written in
their foreheads. Having the father's name written on their foreheads.
And I heard a voice from heaven.
And I heard a voice from heaven saying,
as the voice of many waters.
Yes.
And as the voice of a great thunder.
Yes.
And I heard the voice of harpers.
Yes.
Harping with their harps.
Yes.
And they sung as it were a new song before the throne.
They were singing some new songs.
And before
nobody could understand. Yes.
And before the four beasts.
Before the four archangels.
And the elders.
And the elders.
And no man could learn that song.
Nobody could learn the song because they were given to this very, very 144,000 virgins.
But the 144,000.
Yes.
Which were redeemed from the earth.
Which were redeemed from the earth. Continue.
These are they which were not defiled with the woman.
They were not defiled with women. When they said they are virgins, they are not defiled. It means they were pure. It means they were blameless. It means they trusted absolutely God and God only. and they surrender their lives as a living sacrifice unto God. It means they did not actually add anything to the name of the Lord. It means they were not fetish in any way or manner. It means they were upright with God. When they say virgins, they're talking of those who are already even bound. Yes.
For these are virgins.
They are virgins.
These are they which follow the Lamb wherever he goes.
They followed the Lamb, like we said overnight. They trusted completely in the Lamb who created all things, in whom all powers in heaven and earth and the sea reside. The name is Jesus Christ. They followed him everywhere he was going. Yes.
These were redeemed from among men.
These were redeemed from amongst men.
Being the first fruits unto God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
They were the first fruits. They were the ones that were actually raised when Christ broke the grave. When he went into hell and released the saints. The point I'm driving to you, when you read Revelation chapter 7, you may be confused. But it ends, they don't say, saying, I will ask them to first sanctify 144,000, 12,000 from the root, from the outside tribe of these, 12,000. When they're talking of Israelites, you and me are considered as Israelites. Because we have been grafted into that olive vine. Because only Israelites will be in heaven. But the particular tribe that will be grafted into is what I don't know. You may be grafted into that of Judah, of Joseph, of Naphtali, of Asher, of Levi, and the like. Depends on how the Lord sees your walk. If your walk is solely before the Lord, you will go into the tribe of Judah or Joseph. You will go in through the gates of the kings, the eastern gate in heaven. The 12 gates are named according to the names of the Israelites, according to the tribes of the Israelites. And the pillars carrying the entire world is upon the Israel, the 12 tribes of the Israelites. So you are already, by your work, you have been identified and aligned with a particular tribe. So when they said Israelites, when they said 144,000, they're talking not specifically of the symbolic Israelites, but of the spiritual Israelites. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So sometimes we need to want to substitute celestial Israelites for celestial, blah, blah, blah. I asked from God one day, what is this all about? Then I then saw Mark, this thing, this
Yamaka
on my head. And I saw it on, I said, but you are celestial. No, you are Israelites. You are Israelites. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So 144,000, it says in Revelation 7, this 144,000, don't harm anybody yet until they are sealed. At the time of rapture, this 144,000 will be taken out of paradise. Paradise will become empty. They will be the first to be sealed. Then those who have died after the firstborn, they will be also sealed. Then you and me that are still living, that are worthy for rapture, we will be sealed. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The point is, this 144,000 that are regarded as firstborn are now moving all about with the Lord Jesus Christ. Wherever he is, they are with him. They've taken missions and commissions even higher than those of the angels. Because they have passed through hardship. There was no sermon there. Maybe one preacher. Maybe one prophet. But yet they stood firm. Right from the time of Moses, Noah, Abraham, Elijah, Elisha, and all the sort, those who have lived. The point is, if the Lord has taken only 144,000 from the time of Adam to the coming of Jesus, if only 144,000 were the ones found redeemable, I want you to think seriously. Even if you don't know math, you should know arithmetic. Hallelujah. It's a very serious issue. There's a big problem there. In 532, in the hymn book, 632 says, in the hymn book, 632, 633.
It is tough. Indeed.
Indeed, it is very tough
to enter God's kingdom.
To enter the kingdom of God.
It's tough indeed.
It is tough indeed. End of the world is closing in.
The world has gone astray. World is ending. Oh, repent now.
Oh,
repent and turn to God.
Repent 633.
Christ is warning from heaven. On your ways.
Your worship.
Shall take you to heaven. If righteous, on your ways.
If your ways are righteous or unrighteous, it will determine where you end up. I'm sorry. It's always very, very tough. I'm always banging on you, forgive me, but the only joy I can have is to say to God, nobody is lost among the flock given to me.
Amen.
It is good for me to make you sorrowful. Like Paul the Apostle says in 2 Corinthians chapter 7, if that sorrow will turn you to the Lord and make you to do right thing, in this place, nobody is anybody. If you want to be somebody, it will not be in voice of grace. Because no matter what you are, God is far more than that.
Yes.
So when you are joining this parish, you must humble your totality. If you want to be seen or to be known, you will never be seen. You will not be known. God is God. He will take you beyond your limit of expectation.
Amen.
You will move into the pinnacle of glory.
Yeah.
Please be steadfast. This new year, move in the strength of Elijah. Move in the determination of Paul the Apostle. Move in the humility of John, the son of Zebedee. It must be well with you.
Amen.
You do it right. That thing which you think is difficult, leave it to God. Unless God is no more God.
He is God.
But if God is God, faithful and righteous, Amen. Almighty, you will receive Amen. Your possession this year.
Amen.
Let us stand up and pray.